I'm Ryan Friedlinghouse, CEO of the world-famous West Coast Customs. What started as a $5,000 loan from my grandfather became this. The most creative and innovative custom car shop on the planet. This is my world, and this is how it's done. Rendering to reality, you'll see it all. Inside West Coast Customs.
Who the hell is this? Crazy. Four tour buses in a row.
So I'm looking out my window this morning and four tour buses show up to the shop. We've had one tour bus here, but four of them all at once. Obviously, it was a big deal. So I went downstairs, knocked on the door, and find out it's the Rascal Flatts. How's it going, man? Can I come in?
Hey, how's it
going, man?
Neighborhood.
See
you,
bro. Oh, brother.
We heard there was a car sale going on.
We're on our way to do our show in LA, Orange County, and we stopped by Ryan's shop, which was one of the best things we could have done because we were absolutely blown away.
So here's some of our cars. From old to new.
What's that yellow in there?
Well, that's a Camaro I did for Anderson Silva.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. We widened the body on it a little bit, but he was pretty crazy about making a Transformer-style car. These are four-door Chargers, so I convert them where I shorten the whole car, lengthen the door, give it a whole new body line.
It's awesome.
I built this one 5 years ago, and then I told myself I only would build 10 of them, so I've built six so far.
Tell me about what you did over here to this Honda CR-V. That's pretty bad, too.
What we did was we used a whole lot of armor all.
Those rims are sweet.
You guys want to see the shop?
Yeah, I'd love to see
show you where we do it. Well, this is big, man. This is the beginning of where it all starts, really. Fabrication. So this is my Merc that I was telling you guys about.
Sweet.
It's pretty crazy. Everybody builds a Merc, so it was like this one had to be different. You know, we did so many different things from the hood to the chop on it, to the body line that we added. And then this next to me is a 56 Chevy Bel Air that we cut the roof off of.
We've got this song called Red Camaro on our new album, and we thought, this is a perfect marriage. We can have Ryan build us a bad machine that can go hand in hand with the launch of the new record.
We're thinking, why don't you build us something? You
know, I'm ready.
A Rascal Flatts ride, man.
Let's do it.
Sweet.
Makes sense. And my dad's gonna love it.
I'm ready to hear this track.
Oh, yeah, man. We want you to hear it.
Yeah, man.
Sweet. It's called Red Camaro.
So it's basically about a car.
Yeah, about a red.
Red
one.
With some T-tops.
Yeah.
No, it feels summer. It feels like you gotta have that loud music in it. It's gotta feel.
Yeah.
I got it already.
Sweet. Got it.
So this is like, you know, just a couple different ones just for different customers that I did some for. Definitely got to do T-tops, right?
Yeah.
It says that the song.
It'd also be cool to put some elements in there since there are three of us.
Like
something that has to do with threes, you know?
So three exhaust tips out the back?
I love that.
That'd be great.
Exactly, man, yeah. It's traditionally, you know, two and four or two together.
You just do three.
So do three of them, man.
I got some good ideas.
Yeah, I mean, this is a great start already.
Right.
You know? We just need it in 2 days.
Oh, okay. Well, there is the window for 3 days.
Oh, three, okay, cool.
Today's one of the days, so I guess you do have 2 days.
So you better get started.
Tonight. No, but I got some really good ideas.
Okay.
So what I'll do is I'll just render it out and maybe shoot you guys an email.
Ryan's got to be the cat to build it, man. I mean, his creativity and just it is hands down the best. So
he's got a lot of work to do. We have work to do ourselves. We got to head off to a show, so we got to hit the road, fellas. Let's go.
Try.
Peace.
Yeah. Y'all take care. See you soon. Come to the show tonight. We're in Irvine.
So they love the shop, and they actually had an idea to build a car for their new album that's about to be released. And they want to call it, and there's a song on the album that's called Red Camaro, so we played it really quick. I got some quick ideas. We went over some renderings, and it was like, let's build it.
Here's another one.
What's up, man?
And another one.
How you doing?
Good. I got some good news.
Yeah?
So I've been working with these guys for a little bit, the Rascal Flatts. They said they have a new album that's about to come out, and there's a song on it called Red Camaro. I was like, oh, this is perfect. So they said, let's build a car to that song.
Yeah, shoot, give me a couple hours. I'll have something to you.
Cool.
Yeah, it won't take any time.
All right. Though.
The guys from Rascal Flatts want something special. So we're taking that stock Camaro and putting that unique West Coast custom stamp on it. This car is gonna showcase their hit song, Red Camaro. So it's gotta be red. But I can't give these guys some standard factory color, so I have to come up with my own West Coast Customs Rascal Flatts Red. The lyrics of this song call for a T-top, so we're gonna follow the lines of the roof and make this look factory. We're also gonna add a new body kit to give this car that high-performance look. We'll give this interior a custom makeover with black leather seats and red trim and with the Rascal Flatts logo embroidered in it. Since these guys are serious musicians, we have to give them a kick-ass four-component sound system that can shake the streets while they drive. To give this car more power and handling, we're gonna put in a supercharger, and I'm gonna get the guys from Petters to install a new suspension system. We're also gonna create an exhaust system with three tailpipes, one for each member of the Rascal Flatts. To finish this car off, we're gonna create a rhinestone Rascal Flatts emblem and slap it on the black custom grille. This is probably one of the most important cars. You know, I always say this is one of the most important cars we did, but this is for a pretty big band. It's based around their song that they're coming out with. It's gonna be one of their singles. And you know, this car's gotta be right. It's gotta be badass. Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
The bib or something maybe.
You break it, you buy it.
We brought some pretty cool new parts for the car.
Just trying to be careful not to go too much.
We gotta put a whole bunch of strength back in the middle.
Until he approves, gotta keep going at it.
Jeff just finished up the renderings. They turned out actually awesome, exactly what I was feeling. So I'm gonna call the guys up here, you know, show them what this car is, what it's, you know, what it's all about, and then play them the song.
They wanna do a supercharger, they wanna do badass suspension in it, big brakes. The biggest challenge we're gonna have, Brian, is the T-tops. We gotta come up with something to do the T-tops. Ish, the interior, it's red and black, so I figure, you know, you kinda do your little magic to it. I wanna do a cool color on it, Kenny. We gotta figure out with George, we come up with our own red. Darren, the music in this, it's gotta be loud.
Okay.
It's gotta sound good. This is like something different because it's actually for a song that they made.
Absolutely.
You know, so it's special. Hopefully that's enough direction and you guys got a good idea. We just gotta kill it on this one. But let's get going, let's get it done.
All right,
cool. Thank you guys.
All right, Eddie, we need to pull the windshield. The back glass, the two quarter glasses, and don't worry about the drop-in glass. We'll pull those out. Okay.
Take the glass out now from the car. One piece, as you see, no crack, nothing.
Okay, so right now, we chose a couple colors for the Camaro, for the Rascal Flatts Camaro. One is this Honda, it's called Formula Red. And basically, it gives me a code right here. I enter it into the computer, and then it gives me the mix-in ratio of the toners to achieve the desired color. I'm gonna use it as my base, and then afterwards, I'm gonna tweak it to make it our own West Coast custom red. So right now, it's giving me 219.3 of T441. Just trying to be careful not to go too much over, because then it'll give me a different color. I'm gonna add bright red, but I'm gonna add a little bit more, just because I want it just a little bit more vibrant than what it is on the color chip. Now, I'm gonna add some of the white, just a standard white. The white, it's gonna basically lighten up the color so it's not as dark. So now, this is our red. I need to do some spray out samples just because with water base, you shoot it and it turns out just a little bit different. But this kind of gives you an idea, so I think it's gonna look really good. So I'm not actually gonna shoot both, I'm just shooting one because the other one's gonna be the different color. I'm probably gonna do one more coat, just to make sure we hide the sealer. You don't want it, the sealer coming through the color. Make sure it's nice and covered. Okay, so now I'm done with this one. I'm gonna go ahead and let it dry. I'm gonna do my second red. It's gonna be different from this one. I already have something in mind, which should be a little bit more vibrant, give it more pop, you know, just so it can really stand out. Then go ahead and tear coat them and then show them to Ryan and see which one he likes best.
Right now, just covering up the dash because we're getting ready to cut the center of the roof out. I already got the roof all marked out where we're gonna cut it out at. Back here, we got a really complicated cut because of the way we decided to do this. The actual molding comes way back here, and normally you would cut it here, but the problem is you're gonna have a little piece, you're gonna have a line and a line, it's gonna look crappy. So we decided we're gonna cut in here and then back and then up. So that way, whenever the roof comes back on, it'll just be one line where the window is. It'll look a lot cleaner, but it's gonna take 10 times more work to do it. But we wanna do it nice, and we don't wanna cut any corners and do it half-assed, so.
I'm gonna cut it with the die grinder first, because I can make the line nice and clean. And then we'll run through with the Sawzall to cut the inside, because the Sawzall doesn't make a very clean cut. It's more jagged. This makes a little bit cleaner cut, so.
This is the actual brace that was in here. And I took it out first because as you can see how it covers my cut, I don't want to cut through this little section of this right here and make it all bounce around. I'm already going to have that issue everywhere else. So I was able to take this one out pretty easily. And then once we're all done, I'll be able to go back and trim it and then put it all back in. My cut right here. Starting to come through, but now I'm hitting in this area. That's why it's really hard to cut. All these shapes are here for a reason. They're for strength. And that's what we got to put back in the middle of the car once we're done. We got to put a whole bunch of strength back in the middle. This back here is going to be a lot harder than this was, but this came out nice and clean. That's good, I like it. I'm gonna hop in there and check it out, see what it feels like. See what it'll be like with the wind blowing through all my hair, you know? Makes it a lot cooler car, especially in California. This is the way they all should be, so I don't know why they quit making them, but I think they should start remaking them. After we're done, maybe they can copy what we did and we can show them how to do it.
You wanted some pearl, right? Mm-hmm. I added that ice pearl
mm-hmm.
and the white ice, but it's two different reds.
I like this.
Digging that one more? Yeah.
Yeah.
Deeper red?
Yeah. With the sparkles. Unless we want to go brighter, like a brighter red, like more of a candy style red.
You want it to really just stand
yeah.
out.
Yeah. Okay. Almost like that candy kind of feeling. With some pearl in it, I think it'll look good.
Yeah, we could do the Hummer and then definitely add some more like pop to it until he approves. Gotta keep going at it.
So my friend Mike from Street Scene stopped by. He brought us his brand new body kit for the new Camaro. I was thinking, you know, this car's got to really stand out from the ordinary Camaro. Let's put a body kit on it. I reached out to him. This is the first one out. We're going to put it on this car and stand back, and hopefully it looks badass. How you doing?
Good, man. How are you?
He always brings something new every time.
We brought some pretty cool new parts for the car. This is the new Camaro rear fascia. Instead of running the exhaust out the corners, we're going to run the exhaust out the center. So that should look pretty good with a three-piece exhaust out the center. And then our three-piece rear spoiler, rear deck spoiler. It's going to go over the rear deck for the car, and you'll still be able to open the trunk. It should give us a full SS looking, pretty neat race car look to the whole thing. So a little more of a Trans Am racer, road racer look.
Haven't cut some metal in a while. It's time to cut some metal. You can still see straight, see?
Yeah, that's good. That's perfect.
So we're officially T-topped.
Yes.
All right, let's officially go to lunch.
All right.
Let's do this. That was fun.
That was fun.
That was good.
See? You need to come out here more often.
I do. I need to work with you more often. It makes me happy.
Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
The car that Ryan is building here would be a whole lot faster.
Oh, man. Oh, I've been looking from the bright side.
From there, do something.
I don't know. I'm not a cowboy.
So Pete from Petters is here to help us out with the suspension. Since we're upgrading everything on this car, we really want the suspension to be perfect. Petters suspension is the best in the business.
We're putting on what we refer to as a pace car package. It's the same stuff that was on the Indianapolis pace car and all the NASCAR pace cars that GM had out on the tracks this year. So it's a set of front and rear sway bars, or 27 millimeter bars. We're putting on a set of triple adjustable XA coilovers, and we're putting in rear subframe inserts and front radius bush inserts. All these are designed to reduce compliance in the suspension and take advantage of what we think is the best chassis that GM's built and maybe anybody's got on the road today. This is a XA coilover. It's a 46 millimeter monotube. The spring adjusts with a separate seat from the height adjustment. That means that the preload on the coil stays the same regardless of the height. Another unique advantage to a Petters coilover is we've made this clevis 10 millimeters wider than the OE. In a Camaro, the rear track is greater than the front track. That contributes to understeer. By adding this 10 millimeters to the clevis, we widen the front track and reduce understeer. The rear of the Camaro is bolted in by four big rubber bushes. The rubber bushes have voids for NVH, noise, vibration, and harshness control. People like Rascal Flatts on special builds like this, they're more interested in handling and control than they are in quiet. But essentially what we've done is created a part that fits inside the OE rubber and it fills all the voided spaces and the subframe stops moving around. When a subframe moves in a car, what it does is try to steer the car by altering the direction of the rear wheels. These eliminate that motion. We make the sway bars adjustable front and rear. Each one of these holes alters the strength of the sway bar. I can tell you that a 95% developed Camaro ran the Nürburgring over in Germany in 8 minutes and 20 seconds. The car that Ryan is building here would be a whole lot faster.
How's it look?
Check it out. What do you think?
Yeah.
See, this is more better, don't you think?
Yeah. Yeah, no, it definitely has that.
Yeah, it's got that pop. This will be good. This is it. And it's definitely a big change from that.
What I'm working on right now is the seats for the Rascal Flatts Camaro. You know, we came out with this. You know, it's something really simple, but what we're trying to do is like make the car like a little bit country, between country, heavy metal, see what I mean? But keep it on the original, Camaro style. To me, it looked pretty good. It's nothing fancy, nothing out of this world, but it's something nice. What do you think?
Honestly? Yeah, I like it. I just don't understand it.
I don't understand when you say you don't understand it.
Because I don't understand it. How does this go with the car?
See, the T for T-tops. What? Makes sense, man.
Oh, man.
Looking from the bright side.
I just met with Ish, went over his design of what these seats were going to look like. Again, me and him always have these battles. We don't see eye to eye on some stuff. This time, I'm gonna take a lot of the blame because I didn't really go in there and give him a direction that I think he needed on this one. I like it, it just doesn't fit that car. So we need to go back to square one. I'm gonna bring you that logo right now that I think we should embroider badass in the center and let him embroider it, like really, really good, and then do some kind of design around it. I went up, got him the logo that I think we should go off of, and now I think he's got a better vision of what this thing should look like. I'm gonna come down and check on him before he starts it and make sure it's to go, and then hopefully we get the seat situation and interior situation handled. So here's that logo.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
You see now, once you see that logo, don't you already see a different idea in your head? This I would like to see, like detailed embroidery, like here.
Yeah, yeah.
You know? And then from there, do something.
I feel you.
This right here is your main bulk of your supercharger. It's a root style blower. This is one of the first ones in the States from Harrop. So hopefully This will be a really good launch for their product. So this will add anywhere between 110 to 140 horsepower to the car. And you know, it's made to run with the stock transmission, stock internals. It's reliable, it's powerful, and it's gonna make the car a whole lot funner.
Now we're actually making a stainless steel frame, the exact shape of the roof, all the contours the same. And then we're gonna take that frame and we're gonna take it to the glass company, and the glasses, they're gonna actually use this as the mold to make the glass for the tops. We're just starting off with some strips of stainless steel, and then we take them in our radius roller and we kind of roll it through there to get the shape that we want. And then we like hand bend the corners. And once we get it to fit the exact shape of the roof, then we, you know, we'll weld them all together. And we just slowly, you just slowly have to do it and make the shape. It has to totally touch all the way around the roof, otherwise the glass won't be the same shape.
A little bit more.
The glass that's gonna get in here is gonna be a totally custom-made piece. It's not gonna be something that we just hand a template and somebody goes and cuts a piece of glass for this, because you can't do that. It wouldn't match the roof shape. So all the contours and everything like that, it just wouldn't match. So this has to be custom made from scratch. So this glass, this will be the world's first all glass T-top Camaro right here. So this is really the only way you can do it right and make the glass exactly the same. And then if we want to do more of them, then we just call up and say we need this many pieces of glass, and we already have the molds made and done, and they can just do the glass, and then it's the same every time. Now you can see it's perfect on there.
What Ryan really wants is like cowboy stuff. So I came out with this. I don't know, to me, my personal point of view, it looked like a cowboy stuff right there. I even went to the rodeo this weekend. I was checking out some cowboy boots. Excuse me, let me see. Nah. I'm like, I didn't go to rodeo. But I'm not rodeo, it's over here in California. But you know, the last word is up to Ryan. It looked like Western country cowboy to you? Honestly.
No. I think we'd try to make it clean and simple.
I don't know, I'm not a cowboy.
Well, you seem to be more of a cowboy now. Well, next thing you're gonna do is you're gonna come to work with a cowboy hat and boots on.
I will wear a hat if you buy me one.
It has a lot more direction than the other seats, that's for sure. The other seats didn't make any sense to me.
All right.
Do it, but if I don't like it,
that's what I'm
if saying. If we don't like it.
Well, sometimes I like it, but you don't.
No, sometimes you just say you like it because you don't want to redo it.
I guess.
Right now, I'm molding the door panels. We're gonna do a set of 5 1/4, two sets of 5 1/4 in each door. So I made these templates out, cut out the door panel, bonded them to the door panel, and I got an actual insert that's gonna go in here. We're gonna pivot the speakers at a little angle, mold it all together, sand it down, smooth it out real nice so Ish can go ahead and wrap the door panel. Make it all one piece.
So that's it, Kenny, when it's done, and once I weld it, that'll
be weld it, put it back on the thing. We'll make a square frame out of steel.
Okay.
Little 4-inch extensions out of stainless.
Just to stand it up like that?
Well, it's got to have a parallel surface now to sit upside down, right?
Oh, okay. So we'll just make it quick. Go upside down like that.
Yeah, so it's got to be on a framework that holds this thing like this inside the oven.
And then the glass sits on here and goes that way.
Yep. Looks good. They see number one frame's done. The way it works is that pretend this is a piece of glass. You know, this is the template that I cut off the roof already.
Yeah, and it would be flat.
So yeah, it'll be totally flat piece of glass. They're gonna drape this piece of glass that's totally flat on here. The heating elements are gonna come down and actually drape it and make it sit just like this piece of cardboard.
Right now I'm just getting the wiring ran, getting everything set for the speakers. We got all the wires, all the speaker wires back here. We just ran it through the vehicle. I'm gonna start doing the RCAs after all this and then get the radio installed. We're actually using all of our West Coast Customs line from Diamond Audio. So this whole vehicle is going to be all the new West Coast Custom branding that we have with Diamond.
Darren!
Yo!
I got some goodies. So what I got is our first run of the West Coast speakers.
Look at that, nifty, huh?
Uh-huh. Looks good. I haven't even seen these yet. And it's the real deal. It's not some junk with our logo on it.
It's the actual D3, so, right?
Yeah, it's a real D3. So it's a good speaker, and it's going to be affordable, which is good. You know, the whole thing about this Best Buy deal is these are like top of the line stuff. with our logo on it, but at an affordable price.
Yeah.
So there you go. That's your gift.
Sweet.
I'm actually putting the latch mechanisms in the into the body of the car. The part that there's a rod that mounts. You turn a handle and the rod goes out and it goes into a bracket, and that's, I'm mounting the actual brackets into the car on all four sides. And then that way, once I get those in, then I can do my latch mechanism, make it all line up and match really good. Slide this in to the right height, trim it to fit and weld it in. So whenever they take off the trim panels, they can get to the bolts to adjust it and it'll be part of the car. So it'll be really, it'll be just like factory, like it came that way. So if anything ever was to go wrong, you can just go to the dealer and buy a factory Chevy piece. You're not having to go have somebody custom make you anything. It'll bolt right in.
So today we had a little special treat for the guys from our friends at Stanley. You know, the guys really work hard here, and it's fun to be able to have relationships with different partners that they send us a boatload of stuff. And I, you know, I'm able to hand it out to the guys as gifts and as thank yous for really working as hard as they do.
I really love Ryan's present, but I know he has a purpose behind those presents, more work. Am I right?
Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
You come to work with cowboy boots, shorts, and a hat.
Look like Bart Simpson with a cowboy hat.
You laughing at that.
To HRE Performance Wheels.
Hey, Rory, what's going on?
What's happening, Mickey?
You got some rims for me?
Yeah, we brought your hoops.
Very good. Well, let's get you back to the assembly area and get those things assembled.
What's interesting, these are three-piece wheels, but one of the really important pieces is the fourth piece. And for us, that's the fastener. And this is a high-strength ARP racing fastener. They're unique because most of the industry uses a high-strength chrome steel, and these have none of the issues, none of the fatigue, none of the strength issues. And the only thing is these are really, really expensive.
Yeah, stainless.
The wheels are complete. They look beautiful. I think Ryan will be extremely excited when he sees these wheels.
Hi, buddy. What do you think?
I like it.
You like it?
I like it so much that I'm willing to make a bet with you.
Okay.
Let's do this.
All right.
I went through a lot of research, and most of the boots, jackets, cowboy jackets, boots, they look like, not the same, but sort of.
Okay.
So if the guys from Roscoe Flats doesn't like the design, I show up to work the next day with some cowboy shorts, cowboy boots and a hat. If they like it, you come to work with cowboy boots, shorts, and your hat. Or a fine of $500.
All right, deal. It looks, you know, I'm gonna say it doesn't really look that bad. I think it looks okay. It's definitely different from the normal stuff that we do, which I think is important on this build. And I hope they like it, you know. If they don't like it, then Ishmael's gonna lose his bet and he's gonna have to do what he's gotta do.
Nobody makes anything glass T-top for one of these cars. So this is gonna be the first one. So in that sense, you wanna take your time and do it right, because I'm sure that once this is done and people see how nice it is, I mean, it looks like it came from the dealer when the pieces are all in there. And if we take our time and do it right now, and I'm making patterns in case we ever do another one, then I'm sure we're gonna get a lot more people that are gonna wanna do these. This is, I mean, this is a car that GM never built that everybody wanted them to build. You know, there's a lot of figuring and with the rubbers and the seals to make it not only look good when the top is on and off, but seal and not get, you know, water inside, leak, wind noise, all that. You have to think about all that stuff. And I want it to be like, you know, 5-10 years down the road, you see this car, it all still works and everything is nice. You know what I mean? We're not building it for a month or just to give them the car. We're building this to last for a long time.
At the end of this build, there's one thing on this car that you'll be able to look at and not know if it's factory or if it's custom, and it's definitely the T-top.
Boss man.
So Kelly from Crystal Ninja just showed up. She brought us some of the emblems that she made for us custom for these guys. I mean, the cool thing about them is there's a ton of gemstones. It looks like one of their huge belt buckles they would wear. I think they're going to love them. Me and Brian have some mixed feelings with them, but hey, you know what? We're not country, so hopefully they're going to love them. They're gonna make you want belt buckles for them now, custom made.
That's right, great. Huh?
Yep, easy.
I'll go hide these until we're ready for them.
Yeah.
Okay.
Don't be trying to wear them.
So Danny right now is working on the exhaust system. One of the key points of this car was doing three exhaust tips coming out the back since there's three members of the band. I thought that would be pretty cool. The issue we have is the exhaust system that we use only has two out, so it's only usually a dual exhaust. So he's got to come up with a way to make it a three outlet.
So this one will go in and fit right in between these two right here. And that way all of them will work.
Since we have three tips, if you just run into two, you can get a little bit better flow if you run it out of all three of those. We want them all to work and to be functional.
So what I'm doing right now is I'm gonna make a cardboard pipe. It'll be a lot easier to work with instead of cutting steel. What I'll do is I'll get real close with this pipe and then, you know, transfer it. See, now I'll know where to cut my pipe at. Now I gotta cut this beast. This is a tight fit I'm talking about right here. See that up there? I got a gap. So what I'll do is I'll end up filing more of this edge so it'll sink in more. I'll get that nice and tight. Since it is a TIG weld, it does have to be a lot more precise. So you can see the exhaust actually coming out through all three tips. It'll be a pretty much even flow all across.
Okay, Ash. I got some bad news for you.
Bad news?
Yeah.
What do you mean bad news?
I just was talking with the Rascal Flats. So look, so I sent him this picture. Mm-hmm. Said, do you like this? He wrote me back this. That means he likes it, so you win. You're the winner. I could have simply lied to you and said they hated it, but you know what? A bet's a bet. Oh, this is my cowboy hat? You already have Rascal Flats cowboy hat. You gotta tell me how I look in this.
You look like Bart Simpson with a cowboy hat. No, you look good, you look good.
You laughing at
me. Rascal Flats really like the seats. So now I'm just gonna be waiting for the day that Ryan is gonna show up wearing some cowboy boots, shorts, and Rascal Flats hat. So I just can't wait.
Yeehaw!
This is the factory latch out of the, I think we got it out of like a 2002 Camaro. And what we had to do is I had to lengthen this rod. So I put another piece of stainless rod in here to lengthen this. And then this one I had to actually just cut and turn to get the angle right to match this car. For anybody that's doesn't know about this stuff, you know, any normal person's they're not gonna wanna mess with that. They're gonna wanna drop it and boom. And the factory ones were like that. So I wanted to make it as much like that as possible. That's it, just like that.
Come on.
Yee-hoo! Right now, we're gonna shoot sealer on the panels that don't have sealer. This way, we'll have uniformity of the whole car. Once I have sealer on those panels, I'll take off the paper and shoot the base coat on the entire car. All right, let's rock and roll, but country western style.
What's up, dude? You ready for this one?
Yeah.
I brought this in just to remind you, this car really is the paint job and the T-tops. I mean, that's really what the song's about, too. So,
yeah,
we gotta blow them away.
Pretty serious stuff. Just gotta make sure it's all mixed right. Don't wanna mess up. All right, let's do this. What I like to do is lay down like just kind of like a bog coat first. Because at times, I've had issues where, like, if I lay it down too wet, it'll open up, so I don't want any problems. This way, it's just kind of like introducing the base to whatever surface we have. Let it dry, and then once this one's dry, I lay down a heavy coat. All right, that's it. That's the second coat. Turn on the blowers, let it dry. We'll be ready for their third coat.
Wow. It looks way better than that little sample card.
Yeah.
Man, it looks good on the whole car.
Oh yeah, and the sun?
And it definitely doesn't look stock.
That's for sure.
That's for sure. So what are we doing? Stripe next?
Yeah, we're gonna do the stripe.
I love it. Good job, George. Good job. This was a good color. This is like our own concoction, right?
Yeah.
The paint job on this car is amazing. George definitely did exactly what I wanted him to do. You know, we went through a bunch of different colors. We picked one. Seeing it on a little piece of metal and then seeing it on the whole car is a huge difference. Car looks unbelievable. Once this build's finished, the guys see this car 100%, they're gonna be blown away. I mean, we did cut all the way down to the paint, to the wheels, to the suspension, the brakes, the supercharger, the T-tops, the interior, everything on it's top notch.
Well, right now what I'm doing is pretty much laying out the stripe that's on the rendering, trying to duplicate that on the car. You want to achieve the most straightest possible line, because if it's crooked, people will point it out and it'll look like crap. But right now this tape's looking pretty good, so I'm gonna go ahead and lay down my vinyl tape.
This tape leaves a nice straight edge.
It's more accurate. It gives you just a clean straight line.
You've heard the saying, measure twice, cut once. Same rule applies here.
Brian?
Yeah.
You have a call on line 2?
Okay, thanks.
You're welcome.
Hello?
Hey, Ryan.
Yeah.
Gary LaVox, brother.
What's going on?
Just real quick, I want to call about the car and stuff.
Yeah.
I was going to see if you could, I know we're kind of on a crunch, but I was going to see if you could. It's possible to get it done maybe even a little bit sooner so we can get this thing revealed, man. We're pumped.
Okay. What are you thinking? Are you guys coming out here or something?
Yeah, we're going to come out and just want to see if we can get it earlier.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, we're close on it. I got to push the guys a little bit harder, but I mean, the car's turning out amazing. I think you're going to be blown away by it.
We're so excited. I can't wait to see it.
So Gary just called me from the Rascal Flats. He basically has some stuff. The guys have a bunch of stuff going on. They're coming out here to LA soon. This car is turning out amazing. I'm actually really excited to show it to them because they're car guys. They're gonna really appreciate what we did, and I think the guys really did a great job on it. So right now, it's gonna move over to the assembly. They're gonna do all the final pieces to it. We need to finish the assembly of it, put the grills in, get the interior in, get the stereo done, and get this car finished.
Do the cars right, Ryan. You're in freaking, these things are beautiful. First time I've ever seen a T-top that actually looks so sexy. It's a great car. Carlos!
Inside West Coast Customs. So me and Brian are driving the car down to Hollywood to meet the guys. Way better than what you could imagine.
Come on in for the real thing.
Get it in for the real thing. Driving the car down to Hollywood to meet the guys. They're doing a video shoot out here, and I think this is gonna be a fun, you know, reveal for me. One, I don't think they're all expecting it really to be here, and I'm gonna surprise them.
I know in a house.
Good
to see you, baby.
Good to see you, man.
Been too long.
Too long.
Oh,
I was missing you guys.
How's that
been working out? What's going on?
No, they just have to sail on smaller clothes.
Pump it up, baby.
What have you been working on?
I've been working on this badass car for these guys. So, you want to see this car?
I'd love to see this car.
Come on, we'll show you around, brother.
Back over here.
Watch your step, baby.
Stage here, and we'll simulate like a big conference scene here.
Okay.
And we'll have a full band set up there and everything. And Gary will be riffing with Justin.
They're gonna build the set around us as we're rehearsing with him. And like the last chorus is gonna be like the set's done. We're blowing it out. The lights
sweet.
Go up.
So it's like behind the scenes kind of shots.
Like
and stuff.
Yeah, just gonna see it being built around us. So it's kind of unique.
That's cool.
Can we hurry up? I want to see the car.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's
we
our
do this
world.
Like today.
That's our world.
Way better than the rendering. Way better than what you could imagine. Super duper duper bad. Look at that badge.
Dude, that's
and it's all Swarovski crystals.
It's awesome.
So one of the challenges I had with Ish, just so you guys all know together, Ish did these seats and I was like, dude, I swear to you, the guys aren't gonna like these. He's like, what do you mean? I did all my research about country and western. This is the way I would do them.
You better get your cowboy boots.
Yeah, I love it.
I love it. What size of your head are you
putting your hat? I do. I love them.
You want to start it?
T-tops.
Oh, dude.
It's like the tune, man, the T-tops.
Yeah. Like, supercharged. So it's super powerful and beautiful. Stereo's awesome. You got to play it. Oh. Turn it up.
Too nice, man.
We gotta take these T-tops off.
All right,
Brian, these T-tops are unbelievable. Like, factory. Show them, Brian.
What we do?
Just, we use all, like, factory Camaro stuff off of the older Camaro for the latches, so it's just as simple as one of those are. You know what I mean? It takes, like, no problem at all.
Like that, baby. Wow.
Can I try the other one?
Yeah, try it. Let's see if it's that easy, right?
Hey. How about
got room in the back for them?
Yep. Do you see the exhaust tips? And they all three work.
Do they really?
Yeah.
That's even
that's great, dude.
All right, I got to show you the trunk.
Dude,
we used all my new product that came out from Diamond Audio, but it's unbelievable.
Speechless, man. I don't even know what to say.
Wow.
I know what to say. You should have made three.
I know.
Please tell all the guys at West Coast that
safety
and
first.
How freaking phenomenal and amazing
please.
The car is.
Sure, I will.
Come on in for the real thing.
Get it in for the real thing.
Get it in for the real thing. Big group hug. We love you, Rhino. He's so gifted and he's so talented and just his attention to detail, just everything that he did is. It's crazy.
But it is cool how he created this red color. It's like a Rascal Flatts red. It's unique to us. It's great.
Just to know that we started out recutting that song and didn't even think about, someday having a car built around the song that we created is pretty mind-blowing, man.
Hey, that's what's so cool about music is that music takes on a life of itself sometimes, and sometimes we get to drive it away.
Ultimately, they love the car. It represents the song Red Camaro exactly the way it needs to. And I think I did a great job. I think the guys back home, worked really hard to make this car 100%. This is probably the nicest Camaro that's ever hit the streets. We build a ton of cars for a ton of different people, and they're not all car people, And these guys are car people. You could tell they honestly loved what we did, and that's a really good feeling. So I think, the one problem we're gonna have with the car with the guys is who's gonna drive it first, and they're definitely gonna be probably fighting over it. So a good news is probably gonna be building three of them.
Right now, I'm molding the door panels. We're gonna do two sets of 5 1/4 in each door. So I made these templates out, cut out the door panel, bonded them to the door panel, and I got an actual insert that's gonna go in here. We're gonna pivot the speakers at a little angle, mold it all together, sand it down, smoothing it out real nice so Ish can go ahead and wrap the door panel. Make it all one piece.
So that's it, Kenny, when it's done, and once I weld it, that'll
be it. Weld it, put it back on the thing. We'll make a square frame out of steel.
Okay.
Little 4-inch extensions out of stainless.
Just to stand it up like that?
Well, it's gotta have a parallel surface now. To sit upside down, right?
Oh, okay. So we'll just make it quick. Upside down like that.
Yeah, so it's gotta be on a framework that holds this thing like this inside the oven.
And then the glass sits on here and goes that way.
Yep. It's good. They say number one frame's done. The way it works is that pretend this is a piece of glass. You know, this is the template that I cut off the roof already.
Yeah, and it would be flat.
So yeah, it would be totally flat piece of glass. They're gonna drape this piece of glass that's totally flat on here. The heating elements are gonna come down and actually drape it, make it sit just like this piece of cardboard.
Right now I'm just getting the wiring ran, getting everything except for the speakers. We got all the wires, all the speaker wires back here. We just ran it through the vehicle. I'm gonna start doing the RCAs after all this and then get the radio installed. We're actually using all of our West Coast Customs line from Diamond Audio. So this whole vehicle is gonna be all the new West Coast Custom branding that we have with Diamond.
Darren.
Yo.
I got some goodies. So what I got is our first run of the West Coast speakers.
Look at that, nifty, huh?
Looks good. I haven't even seen these yet. And it's the real deal, it's not some junk with our logo on it.
It's the actual D3 still, right?
Yeah, it's a real D3. So it's a good speaker and it's gonna be affordable, which is good. You know, the whole thing about this Best Buy deal is these are like top of the line stuff with our logo on it, but at an affordable price.
Yeah.
So there you go, that's your gift.
Sweet.
I'm actually putting the latch mechanisms into the body of the car. The part that, there's a rod that mounts. You turn a handle and the rod goes out and it goes into a bracket, and that's, I'm mounting the actual brackets into the car on all four sides. And then that way, once I get those in, then I can do my latch mechanism, make it all line up and match really good. Slide this in to the right height, trim it to fit and weld it in. So whenever they take off the trim panels, they can get to the bolts to adjust it and it'll be part of the car. So it'll be just like factory, like it came that way. So if anything ever was to go wrong, you can just go to the dealer and buy a factory Chevy piece. You're not having to go have somebody custom make you anything. It'll bolt right in.
So today we had a little special treat for the guys from our friends at Stanley. You know, the guys really work hard here and it's fun to be able to have relationships.
The guys from Rascal Flats want something special. So we're taking that stock Camaro and putting that unique West Coast Customs stamp on it. This car is gonna showcase their hit song, Red Camaro, so it's gotta be red. But I can't give these guys some standard factory color, so I have to come up with my own West Coast Customs Rascal Flats Red. The lyrics of this song call for a T-top, so we're gonna follow the lines of the roof and make this look factory. We're also gonna add a new body kit to give this car that high performance look. We'll give this interior a custom makeover with black leather seats and red trim and with the Rascal Flats logo embroidered in it. Since these guys are serious musicians, we have to give them a kick-ass four-component sound system that can shake the streets while they drive. To give this car more power and handling, we're gonna put in a supercharger, and I'm gonna get the guys from Petters to install a new suspension system. We're also gonna create an exhaust system with three tailpipes, one for each member of the Rascal Flats. To finish this car off, we're gonna create a rhinestone Rascal Flats emblem and slap it on the black custom grille. This is probably one of the most important cars. You know, I always say this is one of the most important cars we did, but this is for a pretty big band. It's based around their song that they're coming out with. It's gonna be one of their singles. And you know, this car's gotta be right. It's gotta be badass. Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
Prepare for something maybe.
Break it, you buy it.
We brought some pretty cool new parts for the car.
Just trying to be careful not to go too much.
We gotta put a whole bunch of strength back in the middle.
Until he approves, gotta keep going at it.
Jeff just finished up the renderings. They turned out actually awesome, exactly what I was feeling. So I'm gonna call the guys up here, you know, show them what this car is, what it's, you know, what it's all about, and then play them the song.
They wanna do a supercharger, they wanna do badass suspension in it, big brakes. The biggest challenge we're gonna have, Brian, is the T-tops. We gotta come up with something to do the T-tops. Ish, the interior, it's red and black, so I figure, you know, you kinda do your little magic to it. I wanna do a cool color on it, Kenny. We gotta figure out with George, we come up with our own red. Darren, the music in this, it's gotta be loud.
Okay.
It's gotta sound good. This is like something different because it's actually for a song that they made.
Absolutely.
You know, so it's special. Hopefully that's enough direction and you guys got a good idea. We just gotta kill it on this one. But let's get going. Let's get it done.
All right,
cool. Thank you guys.
All right, Eddie, we need to pull the windshield, the back glass, the two quarter glasses, and don't worry about the drop-in glass. We'll pull those out.
Okay. Take the glass out now from the car. One piece, as you see, no crack, nothing.
Okay, so right now,
they can go hand in hand with the launch of the new record.
We're thinking, why don't you build us something?
I'm ready.
A Rascal Flats ride, man.
Let's do it.
Sweet.
Makes sense. And my dad's gonna love it.
I'm ready to hear this track.
Yeah, man. We want you to hear it.
Yeah, man. Sweet. It's called Red Camaro.
So it's basically about a car.
Yeah, about a red. Yeah. Red.
About a red, red, red,
red. Yeah, red one.
With some T-tops.
Yeah.
No, it feels summer. It feels like you gotta definitely gotta have that loud music in it. It's gotta feel.
Yeah.
I got it already.
Sweet. Got it.
So this is like, you know, just a couple different ones, just for different customers that I did some for.
Definitely got to do T-tops, right?
Yeah.
So it says that the song.
It'd also be cool to put some elements in there since there are three of us.
Like
something that has to do with threes, you know?
The three exhaust tips out the back?
I love that.
That'd be great.
Exactly, man, yeah. It's traditionally, you know, two or two and four or two together.
You just do three.
So do three of them, man.
I got some good ideas.
Yeah. I mean, this is a great start already.
Right.
You know? We just need it in 2 days.
Oh, okay. Well, there is the window for 3 days.
Oh, three. Okay, cool.
Today's one of the days, so I guess you do have 2 days.
So you better get started.
Tonight. No, but I got some really good ideas.
Great.
So what I'll do is I'll just render it out and maybe shoot you guys an email.
Ryan's got to be the cat to build it, man. I mean, his creativity and just it is hands down the best. So
he's got a lot of work to do. We have work to do ourselves. We got to head off to a show, so we got to hit the road, fellas. Let's go.
Try it.
Peace.
Yeah. Y'all take care. See you soon. Come to the show tonight. We're in Irvine.
So they loved the shop, and they actually had an idea to build a car for their new album that's about to be released. And they want to call it, and there's a song on the album that's called Red Camaro, so we played it really quick. I got some quick ideas. We went over some renderings, and it was like, let's build it.
Here's another one.
What's up, man?
And another one.
How you doing?
Good. I got some good news.
Yeah?
So I've been working with these guys for a little bit, the Rascal Flatts. They said they have a new album that's about to come out, and there's a song on it called Red Camaro. I was like, oh, this is perfect. So they said, let's build a car to that song.
Yeah, shoot, give me a couple hours. I'll have something to you.
Cool.
Yeah, it won't take any time.
All right.
The guys from Rascal Flatts want something special. So we're taking that stock Camaro and putting that unique West Coast custom stamp on it. This car is gonna showcase shop, and they actually had an idea to build a car for their new album that's about to be released. And they wanna call it, and there's a song on the album that's called Red Camaro, so we played it really quick. I got some quick ideas. We went over some renderings, and it was like, let's build it.
Here's another one.
What's up, man?
And another one.
How you doing?
Good. I got some good news.
Yeah?
So I've been working with these guys for a little bit, the Rascal Flatts. They said they have a new album that's about to come out, and there's a song on it called Red Camaro. I was like, oh, this is perfect. So they said, let's build a car to that song.
Yeah, shoot, give me a couple hours. I'll have something to you.
Cool.
Yeah, it won't take any time.
All right.
The guys from Rascal Flatts want something special. So we're taking that stock Camaro and putting that unique West Coast custom stamp on it. This car is gonna showcase their hit song, Red Camaro. So it's gotta be red. But I can't give these guys some standard factory color, so I have to come up with my own West Coast Customs Rascal Flatts Red. The lyrics of this song call for a T-top, so we're gonna follow the lines of the roof and make this look factory. We're also gonna add a new body kit to give this car that high-performance look. We'll give this interior a custom makeover with black leather seats and red trim and with the Rascal Flatts logo embroidered in it. Since these guys are serious musicians, we have to give them a kick-ass four-component sound system that can shake the streets while they drive. To give this car more power and handling, we're gonna put in a supercharger, and I'm gonna get the guys from Petters to install a new suspension system. We're also gonna create an exhaust system with three tailpipes, one for each member of the Rascal Flatts. To finish this car off, we're gonna create a rhinestone Rascal Flatts emblem and slap it on the black custom grille. This is probably one of the most important cars. You know, I always say this is one of the most important cars we did, but this is for a pretty big band. It's based around their song that they're coming out with. It's gonna be one of their singles. And you know, this car's gotta be right. It's gotta be badass. Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
Prepare for something maybe.
Break it, you buy it.
We brought some pretty cool new parts for the car.
Just trying to be careful not to go too much.
We gotta put a whole bunch of strength back in the middle.
Until he approves, gotta keep going at it.
Jeff just finished up the renderings. They turned out actually awesome, exactly what I was feeling. So I'm gonna call the guys up here, you know, show them what this car is, what it's, you know, what it's all about, and then play them the song.
They wanna do a supercharger, they wanna do badass suspension in it, big brakes. The biggest challenge we're gonna have, Brian, is the T-tops. We gotta come up with something to do the T-tops. Ish, the interior, it's red and black, so I figure, you know, you kinda do your little magic to it. I wanna do a cool color on it, Kenny. We gotta figure out with George, we come up with our own red. Darren, the...
won't take any time.
All right. The guys from Rascal Flatts want something special. So we're taking that stock Camaro and putting that unique West Coast custom stamp on it. This car is gonna showcase their hit song, Red Camaro, so it's gotta be red. But I can't give these guys some standard factory color, so I'll have to come up with my own West Coast Customs Rascal Flatts Red. The lyrics of this song call for a T-top, so we're gonna follow the lines of the roof and make this look factory. We're also gonna add a new body kit to give this car that high performance look. We'll give this interior a custom makeover with black leather seats and red trim, and with the Rascal Flatts logo embroidered in it. Since these guys are serious musicians, we have to give them a kick-ass four-component sound system that can shake the streets while they drive. To give this car more power and handling, we're gonna put in a supercharger, and I'm gonna get the guys from Petters to install a new suspension system. We're also gonna create an exhaust system with three tailpipes, one for each member of the Rascal Flatts. To finish this car off, we're gonna create a rhinestone Rascal Flatts emblem and slap it on the black custom grille. This is probably one of the most important cars. You know, I always say this is one of the most important cars we did, but this is for a pretty big band. It's based around their song that they're coming out with. It's gonna be one of their singles. And you know, this car's gotta be right. It's gotta be badass. Coming up on Inside West Coast Customs.
We pay up for something, maybe.
You break it, you buy it.
We brought some pretty cool new parts for the car.
Just trying to be careful not to go too much.
We gotta put a whole bunch of strength back in the middle.
Until he approves, gotta keep going at it.
Jeff just finished up the renderings. They turned out actually awesome, exactly what I was feeling. So I'm gonna call the guys up here, you know, show them what this car is, what it's, you know, what it's all about, and then play them the song.
They wanna do a supercharger, they wanna do badass suspension in it, big brakes. The biggest challenge we're gonna have, Brian, is the T-tops. We gotta come up with something to do the T-tops. Ish, the interior, it's red and black, so I figure, you know, you kinda do your little magic to it. I wanna do a cool color on it, Kenny. We gotta figure out with George, we come up with our own red. Darren, the music in this, it's gotta be loud.
Okay.
It's gotta sound good. This is like something different because it's actually for a song that they made.
Absolutely.
You know, so it's special. Hopefully that's enough direction and you guys got a good idea. We just gotta kill it on this one. But let's get going, let's get it done.
All right,
cool. Thank you guys.
All right, Eddie, we need to pull the windshield, back glass, the two quarter glasses, and don't worry about the drop-in glass. We'll pull those out.
Okay. Take the glass out now from the top.
Sweet. It's pretty crazy. Scott, I mean, everybody builds a Merc, so it was like this one had to be different. You know, we did so many different things from the hood to the chop on it to the body line that we added. And then this next to me is a 56 Chevy Bel Air. That we cut the roof off of.
We've got this song called Red Camaro on our new album, and we thought this is a perfect marriage. We can have Ryan build us a bad machine that can go hand in hand with the launch of the new record.
We're thinking, don't you build us something?
I'm ready.
A Rascal Flatts ride, man.
Let's do it.
Sweet.
Makes sense. And my dad's gonna love it.
I'm ready to hear this track.
Yeah, man. We want you to hear it.
Yeah, man.
Sweet. It's called Red Camaro.
So it's basically about a car.
Yeah, about a red.
Red one. With some T-tops.
Yeah.
No, it feels summer. It feels like you gotta have that loud music in it. It's gotta feel.
Yeah.
I got it already.
Sweet.
So this is like, you know, just a couple different ones just for different customers that I did some for. Definitely got to do T-tops, right?
Yeah.
So it says that the song.
It'd also be cool to put some elements in there since there are three of us.
Like something
that has to do with threes, you know?
The three exhaust tips out the back?
I love that.
That'd be
exactly, man. Yeah, it's traditionally, you know, two and four together.
You just do three.
Do three of them, man.
I got some good ideas.
Yeah. I mean, this is a great start already. Right. You know, we just need it in 2 days.
Well, there is the window for 3 days.
Oh, three. Okay, cool.
Today's one of the days, so I guess you do have 2 days.
So you better get started
tonight. No, but I got some really good ideas. Okay. So what I'll do is I'll just render it out and maybe shoot you guys an email.
Ryan's got to be the cat to build it, man. I mean, his creativity and just it is hands down the best. So
he's got a lot of work to do. We have work to do ourselves. We got to head off to a show, so we got to hit the road, fellas. Let's go.
Try it.
Peace.
Yeah, y'all take care. See you soon. Come to the show tonight. We're in Irvine.
So they loved the shop, and they actually had an idea to build a car for their new album that's about to be released. And they want to call it, and there's a song on the album that's called Red Camaro, so we played it really quick. I got some quick ideas. We went over some renderings, and it was like, let's build it.
Here's another one.
What's up, man?
And another one.
How are you doing?
Good. I got some good news.
Yeah?
So I've been working with these guys for a little bit, the Rascal Flatts. They said they have a new album that's about to come out, and there's a song on it called Red Camaro. Because we were absolutely blown away.
So here's some of our cars. From old to new to old.
Badass. What's that yellow in there?
Well, that's a Camaro I did for Anderson Silva.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah.
We widened the body on it a little bit. But he was pretty crazy about making a Transformer-style car. These are four-door chargers.
Yeah.
So I convert them where I shorten the whole car, lengthen the door, give it a whole new body line.
Awesome.
I built this one 5 years ago, and then I told myself I only would build 10 of them, so I've built 6 so far.
Tell me about what you did over here to this Honda CR-V. That's pretty bad, too.
What we did was we used a whole lot of Armor All.
Those rims are sweet.
You guys want to see the shop?
Yeah, I'd love to see the
shop. Show you where we do it.
Well, this is big, man.
This is the beginning of where it all starts, really. Fabrication. So this is my Merc that I was telling you guys about.
Sweet.
It's pretty crazy. Scott, I mean, everybody builds a Merc, so it was like this one had to be different. You know, we did so many different things from the hood to the chop on it to the body line that we added. And then this next to me is a 56 Chevy Bel Air that we cut the roof off of.
We've got this song called Red Camaro on our new album, and we thought this is a perfect marriage. We can have Ryan build us a bad machine that can go hand in hand with the launch of the new record.
We're thinking, why don't you build us something?
I'm ready.
A Rascal Flatts ride, man.
Let's do it.
Sweet.
Makes sense. And my dad's gonna love it.
I'm ready to hear this track.
Yeah, man. We want you to hear it.
Yeah, man.
Sweet. It's called Red Camaro.
So it's basically about a car.
Yeah,
about a red.
red one. With some T-tops.
Yeah.
No, it feels summer. It feels like you gotta have that loud music in it. It's gotta feel.
Yeah.
I got it already.
Sweet.
So this is like, you know, just a couple different ones just for different customers that I did some for. Definitely got to do T-tops, right?
Yeah.
So it says that the song.
It'd also be cool to put some elements in there since there are three of us.
Like
something that has to do with threes, you know?
So three exhaust tips out the back?
I love that.
That'd be great.
Exactly, man, yeah. It's traditionally, you know, two and four together.
You just do three.
So do three of them, man.
I got some good ideas.
Yeah. I mean, this is a great start already.
Right.
You know? We just need it in 2 days.
Well, there is the window for 3 days.
Oh, three. Okay, cool.
Today's one of the days, so I guess you do have 2 days.
So you better get started
tonight. No, but I got some really good ideas.
Okay.
So what I'll do is I'll just render it.
Functionable. So what I'm doing right now is I'm going to make a cardboard pipe. It'll be a lot easier to work with instead of cutting steel. What I'll do is I'll get real close with this pipe and then, you know, transfer it. See, now I'll know where to cut my pipe at.
Now I gotta cut this beast.
This is a tight fit I'm talking about right here. See that up there? I got a gap. So what I'll do is I'll end up filing more of this edge so it'll sink in more. I'll get that nice and tight. Since it is a TIG weld, it does have to be a lot more precise.
so you could see the exhaust actually coming out through all three tips. It'd be a pretty much even flow all across.
Okay, Ash, I got some bad news for you.
Bad news?
Yeah.
What do you mean bad news?
I just was talking with the Rascal Flats. So look, so I sent him this picture. Mm-hmm. Said, do you like this? He wrote me back this. That means he likes it, so you win. You're the winner. I could have simply lied to you and said they hated it, but you know what? A bet's a bet. Oh, this is my cowboy hat? You already have, oh, Rascal Flatts cowboy hat. You gotta tell me how I look in this.
You look like Bart Simpson with a cowboy hat. No, you look good, you look good.
You laughing at me, right?
Rascal Flatts like, really like the seats. So now I'm just gonna be waiting for the day that Ryan is gonna show up wearing some cowboy boots, shorts, and Rascal Flatts hat. So I just can't wait.
Yeehaw!
This is the factory latch out of the, I think we got it out of like a 2002 Camaro. And what we had to do is I had to lengthen this rod. So I put another piece of stainless rod in here to lengthen this. And then this one I had to actually just cut and turn to get the angle right to match this car. For anybody that's doesn't know about this stuff, you know, any normal person's gonna, they're not gonna wanna mess with that. They're gonna wanna drop it and boom. And the factory ones were like that. So I wanted to make it as much like that as possible. That's it. Just like that.
Come on. Yee-hoo!
Right now, we're gonna shoot sealer on the panels that don't have sealer. This way, we'll have uniformity of the whole car. Once I have sealer on those panels, I'll take off the paper and shoot the base coat on the entire car. All right, let's rock and roll, but country western style.
What's up, dude?
The outlet.
So this one will go in and fit right in between these two right here. And that way all of them will work.
Since we have three tips, if you just run into two, you can get a little bit better flow if you run it out of all three of those. We want them all to work and to be functional.
So what I'm doing right now is I'm gonna make a cardboard pipe. It'll be a lot easier to work with instead of cutting steel. What I'll do is I'll get real close with this pipe and then, you know, transfer it. See, now I'll know where to cut my pipe at.
Now I gotta cut this beast.
This is a tight fit I'm talking about right here. See that up there, I got a gap. So what I'll do is I'll end up filing more of this edge so it'll sink in more. I'll get that nice and tight.
Since it is a TIG weld, it does have to be a lot more precise. So you can see the exhaust actually coming out through all three tips. It'd be a pretty much even flow all across.
Okay, Ash, got some bad news for you.
Bad news?
Yeah.
What do you mean bad news?
I just was talking with the Rascal Flatts. So look, so I sent him this picture. Mm-hmm. Said, do you like this? He wrote me back this. That means he likes it, so you win. You're the winner. I could have simply lied to you and said they hated it, but you know what? A bet's a bet. Oh, this is my cowboy hat? You already have, oh, Rascal Flatts cowboy hat. You gotta tell me how I look in this.
You look like Bart Simpson with a cowboy hat. No, you look good, you look good.
You laughing at me, right?
Rascal Flatts like, really like the seats. So now I'm just gonna be waiting for the day that Ryan is gonna show up wearing some cowboy boots, shorts, and Rascal Flatts hat. So I just can't wait.
Yeehaw!
This is the factory latch out of the, I think we got it out of like a 2002 Camaro. And what we had to do is I had to lengthen this rod. So I put another piece of stainless rod in here. Lengthen this, and then this one I had to actually just cut and turn to get the angle right to match this car. For anybody that's doesn't know about this stuff, you know, any normal person's gonna, they're not gonna wanna mess with that. They're gonna wanna drop it and boom. And the factory ones were like that, so I wanted to make it as much like that as possible. And that's it. Just like that.
Right now, we're gonna shoot sealer on the panels that don't have sealer. This way, we'll